Happy New Year, dear viewers, and welcome to our first episode of Immigration Talks this 2024. Ako po si Neil Ventura, isa sa mga senior visa advisor ng Enhanced Visa. Ang topic natin ngayon ay tungkol sa kung ano ba ang dapat mong gawin kapag na-refuse ang visa application mo. Bago natin simulan, marami sa mga nanonood ng videos namin dito sa YouTube hindi nakapag-subscribe. Kung hindi ka pa nakapag-subscribe, please click the subscribe button to get more content like this. With that said, let's get started! Kahit ano pa ang sabihin ng iba, ang Canada pa rin ang isa sa pinakasikat na destinasyon kung saan mo gustong mag-aral at mag-immigrate sa ibang bansa. Canada is known for its high-quality education, work opportunities, and permanent residency programs. Nitong nakaraang mga taon, dumadami na ang international students sa Canada. Last year, Canada welcomed over 500,000 international students dahil ito sa immigration level plans nila. Merong plano ang Canada na tumanggap ng kalahating milyong immigrants kada taon. Canada has ambitious immigration goals, pero hindi ibig sabihin nun, garantisado na ang approval ng application mo. Even with the number of international students who have found success in Canada, the sad truth is, hindi lahat ng application na-approve. Dito pumapasok ang visa reapplication. At dito din pumapasok ang enhanced visa. Enhanced visa has been helping Filipino professionals make the move to countries like Canada and Australia for over 28 years. We have decades of experience dealing with different types of visa applications. At alam namin kung ano yung rason kung bakit na-deny ang visa. Kaya naman, kung sakaling na-deny ang visa mo, huwag kang mag-alala. Enhanced Visa is here to make sure that your journey as an international student in Canada will be favorable. Before we get into details, ano nga ba ang visa reapplication? Ang visa reapplication refers to the process of submitting a new visa application after a previous visa application has been denied. Sabihin natin nag-a-apply ka at na-refuse ang application mo. Hindi ibig sabihin nun na hindi ka na pwedeng mag-apply ulit. In fact, magpapadala ang Canada ng refusal letter kung saan nakalagay yung dahilan nila kung bakit hindi na-approve ang visa mo. This will tell you why your application was refused and how you can improve upon your reapplication. Pero ano nga ba yung mga rason na usually nakalagay sa refusal letter? Well, the common reasons a visa is refused are because of insufficient initial proof, doubts regarding genuine intent, and inability to meet eligibility criteria. Knowing the reasons why your first application was denied is your second chance to do better. Assuming that you have already received and read the details of your refusal, the first thing you should do is to carefully examine the details of your refusal. Alamin mo kung bakit refused ang una mong application. Meron ka bang naipas na expired na document? O baka naman kulang ang supporting documents mo? Baka may mali ka na naisulat sa application form? Understanding what went wrong is crucial for a successful reapplication. Sa reapplication process, kailangan lahat ng documents mo katulad ng academic transcripts, letters of acceptance, at proof of finances up to date at accurate. As mentioned, in reapplying for a student visa, it is important to carefully review the refusal notes and pay close attention to any missing or incorrect documents. Para mas madali, pwede ka rin gumawa ng checklist para wala kang makalimutan sa mga dapat mong gawin. Halimbawa, kung ang visa mo na na-refuse dahil sa insufficient financial proof, dapat makapagbigay ka ng mas matibay na documents na magpapatunay na kaya mong suportahan ang sarili mo habang nasa Canada ka. So matutal, it's beyond important to address all of the specific issues highlighted in your refusal letter. Many applicants have their visa refused because they don't know how to go about immigration matters, lalo na kung DIY yung application. Immigration laws and regulations are challenging and constantly changing. Kaya naman, mas maganda kung meron kang trusted immigration professional tulad ng Enhanced Visa na makakatulong at mag-guide sa reapplication mo. So if your visa gets refused, these immigration consultants can assist with your appeals and reviews, helping you understand your options and improve your chances of approval. This brings us to our last piece of advice. Seek professional assistance. Kapag meron ka ng refusal, dapat maitama mo ang pangalawang application mo. Immigration professionals can help you with this. They know the correct way to go about your application. This way, you have increased the chances of getting approved. Dito sa Enhance, marami na kaming mga kliyente na lumapit sa amin pagkatapos nilang ma-deny sa unang application nila. Usually, DIY applications. Maraming mga community groups sa social media na magbibigay ng advice patungkol sa visa application mo. Pero, dapat mong tandaan na hindi lahat ng application pantay-pantay at pare-pareho. Immigration professionals like regulated immigration consultants and immigration lawyers are the best people to provide you with immigration advice. At Enhanced Visa, we are affiliated with both a regulated immigration consultant and an immigration lawyer. They review refusal letters, create a strategy moving forward, and guide our visa specialists in your application process to ensure favorable results. Kaya naman, kung kailangan mo ng tulong, mag-reapply ka na dito sa Enhanced Visa. Don't jeopardize your travel goals. Trust your reapplication with the visa experts. Kung may mga tanong kayo tungkol sa reapplication process o kung first time mong mag-apply sa Canada or Australia, feel free to send me a message. You can contact me with any of these details. And this, dear viewers, concludes today's video. If you have any ideas for future videos, drop a comment down below. Thanks for watching. Until our next video. Bye!